This is a big pile of 3D printer upgrades, as well as some community designed 3D printed upgrades, and I promised to upgrade my Bambu Lab P1S with all of them. So let's start with the easy ones and work our way up to some of the more advanced upgrades. Starting with the new Panda Cryogrip Pro build plate. It feels like sandpaper, but it's also slightly sticky. I've never felt anything like this before. And it seemed to work just as well as the regular textured build plate in my simple test, except the heated bed was running 25 degrees cooler than the recommended settings for the textured plate. So theoretically, you can save a bit on your energy bill, and if you're running a business or a print farm, then they could maybe pay for themselves in the long run. And since I have so many build plates now, I also 3D printed this model by Jajom3D to store them all. Okay, next up is the Panda Lux. And yeah, this whole series of Bambu Lab compatible products from BQ and BigTreeTech is called Panda because, well, you get it. Anyway, this light bar was easy to install. I just had to unplug the built-in light bar, plug this board in its place, and then snap the light bar into place with magnets. And because it uses the same port, it functions exactly like the stock light, except it's much brighter and lighting from a better angle. It's just a nice, easy upgrade. Next up is the Panda Door. It's just a door. There's not much to say here except that it's made from polycarbonate, comes in pretty colors, and it's less expensive. Broken glass happens. I've had a few close calls myself, so it's just nice to have different replacement and customization options. There's a bit of flex to it, and the adhesive could look better, but it's a door. It's cheap and it gets the job done, so I don't really care. And because I'm always losing mine, I also printed this scraper by Borgo Tech Space that slots onto the handle. It's a really simple yet really clever design, so thank you for this design. I like it a lot. The next upgrade is Panda Fur, a protective wrap that feels like leather but isn't because it's actually polyurethane. Right now it's available in orange, pink, or brown for the X1 or P1S. Step one is to take the lid off. Whoops. It also comes with a knife and these 3D printable jigs that the knife locks into to make cutting the edges easier. I was silly and got the X1 version instead of the P1S version by mistake, but luckily the only difference is the cutout around the screen, which is close enough that I just slapped it on anyway. And here it is. From a distance, it looks really good. But when you get closer, you start to notice some imperfections. I tried taking it slow and being a very methodical perfectionist, but my cuts weren't the best in places and I could have aligned some pieces better. However, there are issues that are not my fault, like these marks on the left side caused by how the tools were placed inside the packaging, and on the other side are these glue marks that refuse to come out, also caused by poor packaging. So if you do order one, maybe just give it a good look over before you start putting it on. Now, I do like the idea of this upgrade a lot. Realistically, it's not going to offer too much protection, but I'm a simple man and just enjoy bright colors. However, the issues with the packaging need to be addressed before I can recommend this to anyone. Oh, and while I was applying the wrap, I also added in these dust covers by this person, which just cover up the threaded rods. The next upgrade is the Panda Touch. I've taken a look at this in a previous short video, and there's a lot of good, really in-depth videos about this thing elsewhere, so I'll keep this short. It's basically just a screen you can use to manage all of your Bambu Lab 3D printers. You can even connect a whole farm to the same screen. My favorite part though is that it gives you more powerful control over the P1S, which doesn't include a proper touchscreen. It also has a battery so it can run wirelessly, and includes this magnetic charging mount which can be plugged into the internal USB port. I didn't like this included stand, it just didn't work very well for me, so instead I downloaded this bottle from Thigh Wrist Door that lets me mount it a bit off to the side, and it's still a bit flimsy, but it's much better. I've been using the Panda Touch for many months now, and it's a very nice upgrade to have, especially if you've got an AMS hooked up and don't want to mess around with the app or the slicer to update the colors and stuff. So yeah, this upgrade is a clear improvement for the P1S and makes it much more like its more expensive, bigger sister, the X1C. Now, I do a lot of design and 3D printing. I'm not sure if that was obvious, but sometimes I need just a bit more from my projects. And that's where my channel sponsor comes in. PCBWay is an online manufacturing service that does everything from circuit boards to 3D printing, CNCing, and laser cutting. Recently, I designed this Autobot badge for my car, and with PCBWay, I could just upload the file, select the process, material, and surface finish, and PCBWay handled the rest. It's solid aluminium with a chrome plating and looks amazing. I could never make something like this in my own workshop. I also had this phone case 3D printed with clear resin that came out absolutely flawless. I'm making a video about this soon, by the way. And they've also made aluminium 3D printed parts and other great CNC projects for me. The quality of all of these parts are amazing, and if you want to check them out, I put a link down below so you can save $5 on your first purchase. Thanks. The next upgrade is the Panda Hub. It's just a USB splitter designed to specifically fit the P1S. It's meant for if you want to plug the touchscreen in, but also need the additional USB port for whatever else you're running. Threaded inserts and screws are also included, and when you insert them into the 3D printable case and close it all up, it fits perfectly into this little area near the USB port. You can, of course, just use any off-the-shelf USB splitter, but just make sure it fits into the tight space and doesn't interfere with any of the mechanical parts. The Panda Branch is another similar device that adds an additional 4 USB ports to the printer by drawing power from the AMS port. It has a pass-through, so you can still use up to 4 AMSs or your AMS light, and there's also different 3D printable cases available depending on the printer you're mounting to. The provided screws aren't long enough, so I just used some M3 screws I had lying around and it worked fine. And this one is really for the more hardcore tinkerers who have a lot going on, like additional fans or light bars or a nice webcam or whatever, and want to power everything from one place. Now, I'm not really the audience for this, and I'm not sure what people are going to make with this, but I'm glad it exists for the people who need it. And since we're talking about AMSs, let's add one. If you're watching this video, you probably know what an AMS is. If you're going to choose one upgrade, this is it. Now we're getting into some of the more advanced stuff. I was confused when BigTreeTech sent me this. Why would I need another power brick? But it's actually smart and has 3 USB ports. And you can use it by itself with the web interface, or you can sync it to the Panda Touch by tapping it against the power brick. From the screen you can see energy usage, you can turn on and off the USB ports remotely, there's also an option to sync the USB port with the built-in LED light. Plus, there's an auto shutdown mode that automatically turns the printer off when it finishes printing. This is another upgrade that would go hard in a print farm. Okay, the next upgrade is the Panda Revo Hotend. I don't care much about the high flow or whatever the other specs are, I'm only keen for the quick swappability. For some projects I've wanted to switch to a larger nozzle diameter, but it's always just a bit too annoying to do that, especially when I'd have to switch back afterwards. But now, easy peasy. I did this upgrade on my X1C instead of the P1S because I want to change to a 0.6mm nozzle diameter when printing with carbon fiber, and I only ever do that on the X1C. Anyway, this is definitely a worthy upgrade, and I actually might end up getting it for the P1S as well. We'll see. Oh, and while I was inside the X1C, I was also going to install the Panda Claw, which is a hardened steel extruder gear that replaces the default plastic gear. But I forgot and then ran out of time, my bad. It should function just as well as the default gear and maybe be a bit more durable, but I haven't tested it. But please let me know down below if you have. I think this one's really just for if your existing extruder gear needs replacing. So again, I think it's just nice to have different replacement options. And last up is the Panda Jet air duct, which is actually a 3D printed product, which is really cool. It replaces the existing air duct and has a different design that cools omnidirectionally. And it works, it looks nice, but realistically, I don't think I'm ever going to notice a difference in performance when the default air duct already gets the job done fine. And here we are, a heap of upgrades complete. Some really handy and some not so much. I'm going to keep putting them to the test over the next few weeks and months, and I'll make sure to give you all an update at some point. Also, if you have any other suggestions for future upgrades, please let me know. I'm thinking of maybe doing the Hydra AMS upgrade. If you've done one yourself, please let me know how it went. But anyway, please let me know down below if you have any questions. Cheers.